Another classic problem that I really like for its applicability. It does, however, have some trickiness again associated with it when dealing with the minus signs here. So let's take a look. You want to buy a new car, but you can only make an initial down payment of $2,000. So let's go ahead and jot that down. Line up our columns here. Make those dollars. And can afford monthly payments of at most $400. If the APR on the loan, so this is our rate, and this is APR, our annual, is 12%, and you can finance the purchase over 48 months, what is the maximum price you can pay for the car? So the way I think about this is there's really two pieces. The total cost of the car will include the down payment plus the amount that you'll finance. Now, notice here we've got an incongruence between the payment being monthly, a rate being annually, and the number of periods being months, which were 48. So what we're going to have to do for this is we always want to make sure that we have synchronicity between them, and we want to use in essence, what is the smallest? So when we have monthly, monthly, and annual, we want to take this one down to monthly as well. So in making that monthly, fairly simple for us, it's just going to be 0.12 divided by the number of months in a year, or 0.01. What that means is then the amount of a loan you could take out would be equal to, and now this is a present value, and this is something that you're going to want to notate, that a loan is a present value, right? Because you're going to get the money right then so you can drive off the lot with the car. So equals present value, the rate of 1% per month for 48 months. We are going to make a $400 payment. There is no future value to concern ourselves with. So now look what we end up with, a negative $15,000. This is once again where I would consider switching the sign, so that we can now say here's the total car cost would actually be the $2,000 down payment plus the amount of loan here. Now, second part, part B, once we have part A set up, is fairly simple to work through because it says, well, what if we're going to go ahead and finance over 60 months instead? Well, we still have the same down payment. We still have the same $400 maximum monthly payment. We still have a rate of 1% per month. But now we're just going to change our number of periods to 60. And so now you can get a slightly nicer car at $19,982 instead of the $17,189 you could have gotten previous.